Good morning. I'll explain to you why you have every reason to consider my words. You have a wrong and diabolic vision of the existence, and there is every reason to defeat this great nonsense. This diabolic vision is wrong because it is relative one, because it is a one-sided version of the facts. Everyone, in fact, believes the evolution of the universe increasing in the time, because this universe is exactly increasing in the equal and contrary way. The fundamental action of the universe is that of the magnetism and of the antimatter, advancing in their action. Their evolution brings everything towards an existence that exists only in power. This potential existence has the real power to exist only in a relative way. The relative way is a way that is exactly equal and the contrary one. That is a pure and mere reaction to the action of the magnetism and of the antimatter proceeding, advancing in their time. By consequence, electricity and matter move going on in a true returning, which seems a real advancing only because this contrary reality in evolution is observed by the reaction and not by the action in itself, which is the exact opposite of the evolution. As Jesus Christ affirmed, the existence has two opposites going on. The first is of the subject. The second one is of the objects. Our spirit is returning from the future time of the objects, and these objects are going on toward the past time of the spirit. The fact is that every way can be covered only if and when it there is. We cannot construct a bridge founded only on the past time, believing that the opposite foundation there is not yet. We can go toward the bridge only if and when, simultaneously, this bridge is coming toward us, as the famous Mohammed's miracle, that of the mountain. Our real life in action is like the combustion of the hydrogen of a rocket existing in the vacuum. The hydrogen's action is what is truly advancing, and so the rocket is truly not advancing, but returning. As the rocket's hydrogen is condemned to finish, as our spirit's life is condemned to return to its first beginning, which seems to be the spirit's death, only because our wrong and relative consideration of the relative existence. We are wrong because we know very well that our existence is only relative one. But afterwards, we believe with all our diabolic reason that it is not relative, but absolute. We believe, in fact, to have only this life, and believing to have every reason. But what a reason? What? What if is relative one every relative and not absolute? The believing true one, the evolution of the universe, is the most possible nonsense. If we quantify plus one the action and minus one its reaction, the interaction between action and reaction is plus one multiplied by minus one, and the sure result is minus one. However we consider plus one or minus one the true increasing in the time, the result is always minus one. That is, to deny the existence of some existence. The fundament of what can exist only in power, that is God, is compelling all the binary project of the existence to return in power. Every observer, perceiving the binary string going toward his real point of observation, truly observes something like the first page of a book. It is certainly the first page, but when the last page is arrived to the observer's observation, it seems to be become the most back and not the most before. In this poor way, our relative existence is a reaction to what is coming from the future time, and that is really a binary project. But we, wronging, believe that our future exists on the fundament not of the future, but of the past of our observation. We, being truly in opposition to the binary design, we can only react to its perception. We cannot exchange this real objective design. We exist just like the sacred Bible reveals. We are the God's people, now living in this earth of Egypt, being completely slaves of our Pharaoh. A Pharaoh who is the binary project against which we have to react. We all, as the first man, Adam, who eats the famous apple and desire a life in full definition. In this way, the life is compelled to go to the end of everything. But men prefer this eating and this consummation to the renounce of everything is wrongly appearing as primary, real and objective. This consummation is wrongly preferred to the full possess of what is judged only ideal one, but not a real one. The binary project arriving to our attention is ideal one, is divine one, but we lie in the original sin of Adam to can exist in our single subjective spirit only being in the opposition and in the limit. This truth that I am revealing to everything is divine one, because it transcends the reality of the relative appearance of the secondary existence, that subjective of every spirit, of every soul, of a God, essence of every essence, who now, in this obliged, simple and not exchanging example of life, has assumed the cross of the limit, of every possible limit. The supreme aim is to can realize an infinite adventure of all the possible subjective spirits. These souls are as a multitude of God's sons, true and single heirs of God. They are, we are, a full lot who will realize the infinite victory of the absolute power named God. It is a power that can be relatively perceived only through the infinite and real presences of every possible son, good or bad one. Starting from the cross of every limit made person, the absolute God will exalt every personal cross, as Jesus Christ made truly apparent. This is the divine truth. You have not to observe my real pure appearance, but to hear the Holy Spirit of the truth, living in me as in the Father. I am the truth of the Father, the absolute truth. All what is appearing to exist toward future truly exists toward the past time. Only in this way the single person is appearing to be free, to have some possibility to exist in his person, because the truth is everything that is compelled to go in the one point of God, in which everything exists only in power.